Hello. Thank you for looking at our presentation. My name is Svetlana Poroseva, and I will be talking today about drug study of the bio-inspired body shape. This presentation and the study has been conducted at the Department of Mechanical Engineering, University of New Mexico, and my co-authors are Derrick, Charley, who was undergraduate student at our department and recently graduated, and Professor Vorobieff, who is professor at our department. Motivation for this study is very exciting. Axis idea is flying around. Not that any concept came to fruition yet, but if we look at different concepts, for example, here on the slide we have a screenshot from Google search, we can see that many concepts are tiltrotors. Aerodynamics for tilt rotors is yet to be understood fully, and particularly because air axis will be smaller and lighter than existing tilt rotors for military application mostly, such as V-22 Ospreys. So new studies are required, starting from experiments, and this is the objective of our study. Specifically, we are looking not on the entire concept of air taxi, but only of assembly of proprotor and nacelle. Usually, proprotors are located at the top of nacelle. Nacelle incorporates all electronics devices relevant to rotor operation in different positions. It also incorporates usually engines or one engine. So the assembly is of large size, and one would expect significant contribution to the vehicle drag, which is currently unknown, and there could be different designs. So in our study, we investigate not the entire assembly, but proprotor without blades incorporated in the nacelle. This body, combined body, is located so to resemble its position in forward horizontal flight. On the slide, it's shown by a red dashed line, the body we are interested in, and it includes areas 1 and 2. So by a prototype which we developed to consider in this study is actually inspired by a body of a real cicada, which you can see on the photo. So we collected cicada when it was already deceased. Initially, the CAD model was created for simulation, so it was small. But for current study, it was enlarged. And it was created by using Inkscape. So we investigated the dimensions of the image of the cicada, and then approximated by axisymmetric body. It's good to notice that the real body is not axisymmetric, and we also omitted at this stage of research some parts of the real cicada body. So in our design, we compare it with results is ellipsoid, which was created also by using image from NASA simulations of V-22 Osprey rotor. So this is not necessarily real V-22 Osprey design, but we hope it's close to that. So again, initially CAD model was created for simulations, but We have to enlarge it for our study. So our designs consider it as canonical three-dimensional cylinder. We also created a double bullet design, which is a cylinder with smoothed ends by hemispheres of the same radius as a cylinder. And the dimensions for all four designs considered in our studies are shown on the slide in the table. So the cross-sectional area of all four designs was circular, and the maximum value was the same for all considered designs. Length was also the same, except for bio-inspired body, which is larger to preserve dimensions or ratios of dimensions of real body. So this resulted in the ratio of length to diameter of 1.84 for cylinder, double bullet and ellipsoid, and 2.21 for bio-inspired design. So approximately 2 for all of them. So CAD models were created using SolidWorks. Manufacturing process was three-dimensional printing using nylon, and we appreciate help of local company at Albuquerque, New Mexico, Westwind, who produced us with designs using our CAD models. Experimental setup used in the study is a water tunnel with test section dimensions 6 by 6 inches, and velocity ranges from 0 to 0.98 meter per second, and this wind tunnel is located at Fluids Lab and Mechanical Engineering Department of University of New Mexico. This facility was sufficient for us to understand whether performance of bio-inspired design deserves more attention. This slide shows the drag measurements. We measured drag for all four designs in the range of Reynolds number up to 36,400. Reynolds number is based on the diameter of maximum cross-section of designs, which is the same. And on the right figure, you can see drag coefficient, which is normalized by the maximum cross-sectional area. If we look at the drag coefficient picture, we can see that the whole range of Reynolds numbers considered in the current study can be divided on two views which are less than 15,000 and views which are more than 15,000 based on the design performance. So in the smaller range from 0 to 15,000, we can see that the double bullet performance produce the highest drag coefficient. The ellipsoid performance and that of cylinder somewhat comparable. And the bio-inspired design has the lowest drag, which steady reduces with Reynolds number increasing. Exception is only at the lowest Reynolds number, but the bars showing uncertainty in the data, they also show that uncertainty in data increases with reducing Reynolds number. So, if we go to the range of Reynolds number higher than 15,000, we can see that dynamics in the performance of different designs changes. That is, a cylinder is expected to produce higher drag than other designs. The performance of double bullet and the ellipsoid is comparable within uncertainty range, although double bullet perform a little bit maybe better, but the bio-inspired design certainly outperform all three other designs, with asymptotic value at the highest Reynolds number being 0.023. So it brings question how much we can trust to our experimental data. This type of designs are not investigated in details, so not many data are available. We have for comparison experimental data from famous fluid dynamics drag book by Herner, which gave a circular disk drag coefficient of 1.17. For cylinder with close length to diameter ratio, this value is 0.86. Another set of data available is from simulations, recent simulations for finite cylinders at different yaw angles. So at the same position of finite cylinder is considered in our study, and that the Reynolds number about three times larger, but close ratio of length to diameter of two, the result of drag coefficient of is 0.85. So values from experiments and simulations are close, in our experiments at the three times almost less Reynolds number value, we have for cylinder 0.93, which is very close, and particularly taking into account that three-dimensional printing does affect surface, so roughness wasn't taken into account in either of studies. So the conclusion is that our experimental data are of high quality and can be used for comparison with previous data, but also all designs were printed similar for this study, so results are of importance for future work and trustworthy conclusions. So on this slide we show flow visualization at much lower Reynolds numbers we could obtain without perturbation of flow, and we can notice here that Reynolds number has stabilizing effect on strike line behavior around the body. So some perturbations observed at the small Reynolds number of 280 almost suppressed in the bio-inspired design, ellipsoid, and double bullet. The flow around cylinder has separation zones and is disturbed at all three Reynolds numbers, but no separation zone is observed in either of three other designs. Interesting feature we observed is the presence of disturbance in front of cylinder, which is observed at higher Reynolds number. We also can see on the slide additional separation zone on the side, at the side of the cylinder, and we can see that flow is quite disturbed behind the cylinder. So this concludes our presentation with a statement that our experiments demonstrated superior performance of bio-inspired design to compare with other three designs, such as cylinder, double bullet, and ellipsoid, within considered range of Reynolds number, which motivate our future study to conduct experiments at various angles of attack, experiments at higher Reynolds numbers, and simulations. Thank you very much for watching our presentation. And the last slide is acknowledgements, where we show contribution of different support group, but also we appreciate contribution of different students who helped with experiments at different stages.